colleagues from Bank of Zambia. I don't know where they are seated. Maybe if you can stand. Yeah, they had the duties. They can. We have Mr. Cirilo from Western, and now he's leading the dollarist. We have Soa there, Bank of Zambia. Yeah, Bank of Zambia is chairperson, and also this chairperson of the country. You are welcome. We were thinking of sending you to next, but you know, this is why we will be today. But I was told you asked for permission today. So you are welcome and enjoy the Congress.
Thank you. I greet everyone in the name of Sophia.
Glory Jesus.
Glory Jesus.
Glory Jesus.
Thank you, everyone.
It's a very tough day. So I hope we are all geared. We are going to have the which we should have had yesterday, the district and branch report, to open data like that. But today we are going to start with the report on what to report on. After the end of the report, then we have the General Secretary's report, which now talks to you about the status of the union. After that, we are going to have the financial report. I think we are all aware that we have reasons that we explained, and because of that, we are going to have financial reports from 2007 to 2012. The financial accounts, dear Congress, audited the accounts. When they come to you, we don't discuss management accounts. There's a difference. So I hope you went through. The issues to ask on are on audited accounts. Don't take us back to profit and loss accounts. So, questions will be on audited accounts so that we can make progress. If you have never, you are not familiar with the subject, observe. Okay? Because sometimes we waste a lot of time talking on issues that may not add value to our discussion. Because here, as I said, we are discussing policies, we are discussing issues of the union and the way forward. So let's be very, very committed. Let's get your ideas, if you have better ideas, so that we record them. This is your union. So if you have an idea, don't feel shy. Just bring it out. That's why we have the resolutions committee. They will capture your ideas. Some of you are shy to talk, you can still approach the resolutions committee and tell them, this is what I feel we should do, they will talk to you. So feel free to talk to the resolutions committee. Just as you feel free to also talk to the entertainment committee. If you have ideas of how you feel the entertainment should be done, they are there to hear from you. So dear colleagues, I hand over to the chairperson as we start to talk now to our branch reports. Thank you.
So the National Executive Council deemed it fit, according to provisions of our Constitution, to dissolve the committee and appoint an interim committee to take over the running of the district. Again here, we have some of the members of the district who accepted the problem and the mistakes. We have Mrs. Mutale, and my dear friend there, Toela is there. We have Mr. Mwansa, is here. All these were part of that district who accepted that we haven't been working. And they are here today. Due to the foregoing reasons, the National Executive Council deemed it fit, according to provisions of our Constitution, to dissolve the committee, and we appointed an interim. The Lusaka District Committee, the committee was dissolved in the same month, May 2013, at Indola District Committee because of the following reasons. The committee had not held any meeting since 2011, and as such they were in violation of the Union Constitution. The committee had failed to account for the 2009-2010 sports day expenses, even after being given ample time to do so. This contributed to the failure to hold an event in 2011 and 2012. The committee failed to organize district visitations to branches
and failed to attend to members' grievances, forcing members to channel their grievances to the General Secretary's office. The committee had been advised to come up with a budget and to prepare for the launch of the Lusaka District Office, but they failed to do so. After considering the above, the National Executive Council deemed it fit to dissolve the committee and appoint a new committee to take over the running of the district. The National Executive Council put interim committees in Lusaka and Indola to handle the affairs of the union until the time of the Kwadwane Conference, when new committees shall be voted into office. I would like to pay tribute to the following people who came on board to try and help Zofiao meet its objectives. Mr. Luka Chihuahua, the Bank of Zambia. Is he here? Yes, thank you. Mr. Christopher Mpoposhi, Zambia National Building Society. He's at the back. Mr. Gift Nawa, Zanaco. Oh, my word, Mr. Sorry. You look like a Mr., I think. Ms. Florence Mpemba, Blue Finance. Thank you. Mr. Clement Mumbo, Barclays Bank. Thank you very much. Mr. Alfred Chifota, NAPSA. Thank you so much. Mr. Collins Chwati, Indo-Zambia Bank. Thank you very much. Ms. Maria Chikwaka, NATSEF. Thank you very much. Mr. Bwadia Nyongani, Finance, oh sorry, Mr. Ricky Nyirongo, PSTF, thank you so much. Mr. Bwadia Nyongani, Finance Bank. Bwadia, Finance Bank. These are men and women who came to help us organize, reorganize things. I thank you so much for your commitment. Ndola District, we also went to our veteran member who I worked closely with for many years and put him as chairperson of Ndola District, Dikezo Sidilo, Bank of Zambia. Thank you very much. Mr. Christopher Mkange, Workers' Compensation, is not here. I know he's preparing for his wedding, so he's confused about the lottery. Ms. Megan Weupe, First Alliance Bank. Where? She's not here.
She's here.
Oh, there you are. Of course, yeah. Mr. Darius Ozulu, Finance Bank. Thank you very much. Ms. Jacqueline Mandona, Workers' Compensation. Thank you very much. Ms. Etambuyu Ziwa, Barclays Bank. Thank you so much. Ms. Helen's member, Covermont. She's not here. Mr. Lauren Bazima, my own, thank you. You have always been very supportive. Miss Esther Zulu, Zisk. She's not here. Mr. Ian Kunda, NATSEV. Thank you very much. These are again men and women who came quickly to save Zofiao from the confusion of communication. The Lusaka and Ndola interim committees have already come up with plans of action, and we are blessed to have men and women who have actively taken up the challenge of leadership with eagerness to work and produce results. We thank you, dear colleagues, as you clearly put service above self when you took up the responsibility of leadership at the opportune time the union needed your service in the interest of the workers. I think let's give them a big hand. Opening of Lusaka and Ndola and Kitwe District offices. As the resolutions passed at the annual Kwadwane Conference, the Ndola District office was officially opened on 28 May 2012. It is situated at College House, Suite 105, plot number 39 in Ndola. Kitwe District office, as per resolution also passed, the Kitwe District office was officially opened on 29 May 2012. It is situated at Sunham Building, Suite 107, plot number 1097. Lusaka District Office, the dissolved district committee really frustrated the office of official opening of the Lusaka District Office. Therefore, the new district committee shall work towards ensuring that the office is officially opened. It is situated at Permanent House, third floor. I hope I'm right, Mr. Mlenga. Is it third floor?
Yes.
Second floor. Let's make that correction. Second floor. And we would also want to thank Mr. Mlenga, who worked very hard to ensure that this office was given to us by management. collective agreements. The union worked hard during the period under review and concluded on the collective agreements as shown below. I think we are going to have something below there that shows. Mr. President, despite the disturbances we had, we still made sure that we concentrated on our core business, which is collective bargaining. In most institutions, we made very good progress in ensuring that our members received reasonable salary increments. The increments ranged from 500 to 1.2, and a special salary increment was made to finance bank employees at a sum of 2,000 given to employees. Finance Bank has had a lot of problems in the recent past, and some of these problems have been politically motivated disturbances, and this really reduced the morale of all the workers in the institution. The National Executive Council report, together with the management, that I go around and visit employees in various districts, covering Copperbelt, Western, Northwestern, Southern, and Lusaka provinces, with the exception of Northern Province, which I intend to visit after this conference before I hand over to the new General Secretary. This has been approved by National Executive Council. The interim report elaborating the problems facing Finance Bank employees has been presented to management. The National Executive Council and all contact persons in all the districts have already been given the document. The branch officials are expected to engage management in resolving the problems, and where necessary, the National Executive Council shall participate in resolving these problems. Mr. President, Zufiao is the only institution that negotiates throughout the year. This is because we prefer that the negotiations are member-based and not leadership-based. Before signing collective agreements in all institutions, we have consulted our members widely, and only when the majority of our members consent to the agreements, the signing does take place. This is the major reason why our union has not recorded any legal strikes since I assumed the office as General Secretary. This is a plus to the union, the leadership at all levels, the National Executive Council, and to our members, our membership, and of course, a success story with regards to the status of our collective agreement. Below is an update. This is where we give all the information of the status of our collective bargaining and also recognition agreements. The Federation of Free Trade Unions of Zambia, Mr. President Zufiao, has continued participating in various trade union and international development activities because of its affiliation to FFTUZ. And I must report that Zufiao is up to date with subscriptions to FFTUZ. I take this time to condemn those affiliates claiming that FFTUZ is not managing its finances properly. I take you again through memory lane. FFTUZ was registered through a court order, and it didn't have affiliates for a long time. Only Zufiao was its affiliate. The MMD government never recognized FFTUZ until after a court order. The country is now boasting and talking about FFTUZ as the only union of hope of a labor movement in Zambia. Unfortunately for us, most of our affiliates are just setting up their secretariats, and as such, their finances are limited. Therefore, their contribution to FFTUZ has not been easy. To make matters worse, when the MMD government passed a statutory instrument directing all national unions to pay subscriptions at source, the only single doubt is under Congress of Trade Unions, ZCTU, and leaving out FFTUZ. This meant that FFTUZ continued to suffer financially because of this discrimination by MMD. When the PF government came into power, we complained about this, and the government passed another statutory instrument to include FFTUZ. However, what is shocking is that despite FFTUZ calling for meeting of General Secretaries of affiliate trade unions and agreeing that the instrument be effected and the subscriptions remitted to FFTUZ be reduced from constitutional requirement from 25% to 10%, some national unions have been avoiding to pay this amount for selfish reasons. These unions have gone on radio and television to denounce the administration of FFTUZ, citing lack of accountability, failure to hold the quadrennial conference, failure to produce audited accounts since 2008. The cost of auditing accounts, Mr. President, ranges from 20,000 to 30,000, depending on the amount of work and FFTUZ monthly collections are expected to be. FFTUZ monthly collections are expected to be 72,736, but only receive a monthly average collection of 55,200. The monthly administrative budget is 96,000, leaving a monthly deficit of 48,800. The quadrennial conference of FFTUZ would not cost less than 100,000. So those that have been accusing FFTUZ of not holding the quadrennial conference must advise FFTUZ where the money shall come from, because it follows logically that the only source of income for FFTUZ is from its affiliates. I would like to congratulate Zufia for first coming up with FFTUZ together with other unions as a matter of principle and remaining in FFTUZ when all others left, and for having recruited 15 other national unions thereafter. Mr. President, another success story for Zufia. Zufia shall continue to participate in national issues through the FFTUZ. One cannot boast of representing their members effectively if they are not able to participate at national level, national and international level, where everything happens. Zufia is proud to have effectively participated in the following events under the umbrella of FFTUZ: National Policy Dialogue, Unite the Union Steering Committee meeting, ILO Advisory Committee meeting, ILO workshop on the implementation plan and monitoring and evaluation framework of the Zambia Decent Work Country Program, Alliance Dissemination meeting, Teveta Sector Plan, Zambia Center for Dispute Resolution Board meeting, Zambianization Committee meeting, April 2010 Program Advisor Committee for Wage, Zambia Decent Work Country Program Advisor Committee meeting, Consultative meeting on adjustment of the basic needs basket, National Steering Committee meeting on child labor, Conference on Social Security Standards and Social Protection, Social Security Policy Dialogue Conference, International Labor Standards Reporting Workshop, Stakeholders Consultative Meeting, a National Social Pension, Advance the Ratification of Convention 189, Decent Work for Domestic Workers, Technical Committee for Project on Improving Safety and Health at Work through Decent Work, National HIV Policy Draft Meeting at Minister of Labor, and attend a team on Zambia Constitution Committee, ILO Program on Law Growth Nexus Technical Committee, Zambia Labor Law Reforms, Constitution Review Commission, holding meetings with International Monetary Fund and the World Bank, Tripartite Consultative Labor Council, Arbitration and Mediation Workshops, Leadership Development Seminars, Labor Day Celebrations, Submission of the Joint FFTUZ Zufia paper to the Electoral Reform Technical Committee, Parliamentary Subcommittee.